بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدي وحبيبي ونور قلبي أبي القاسم محمد. وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الذين ذاب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. قال الله العلي العظيم في كتابه الكريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: وضرب الله مثلا للذين آمنوا امرأة فرعون إذ قالت رب ابن لي عندك بيتا في الجنة ونجني من فرعون وعمله ونجني من القوم الظالمين. ومريم ابنة عمران التي أحسنت فرجها فنفخنا فيها من روحنا وصدقت بكلمات ربها وكتبه وكانت من القانتين. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد.
I would like to offer my condolences to our Imam of our time, Imam Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman. And to all Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, and especially the Shia of Amir al-Mu'mineen, and especially the Shia of Imam Ali in this community, in this center. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and help us to shape our lives according to the teachings of Zahra alayhi salam, inshaAllah. The ayah I just read is in Surah Al-Tahrim, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about some of the best women in Islam. You know, there is a famous hadith of the Prophet where he says that أفضل نساء العالمين أربعة. The best women in the world are four. Then they ask Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, وما هن? Who are they? The four women who are the best women. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أولهن فاطمة الزهراء عليها السلام. The first is Zahra alayhi salam. And according to some of the narration, they say when the Prophet mentioned, he mentions according to the order, who is the first best and then down. Then the first one the Prophet mentioned was Zahra alayhi salam. Then he said that the second one is Khadija alayhi salam. And the third one the Prophet said Maryam alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. And the fourth one is Asiya bint Muzahim. These four women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about them in the Quran. But the two of them were together in Surah Al-Tahrim. Two of them, Allah talks about them. One of them is Asiya, and the other one is Maryam alayhi salam. In Surah Al-Tahrim, the last few ayahs, Allah talks about them. But I just want us to take a look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them and how Allah describes Zahra alayhi salam. Because sometimes, in order to know how good something is, you need to compare them so you can know who is who. And the Quran does that too. That you look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I chose among all mankind, I chose prophet. Every prophet is a chosen one. Then Allah comes among the prophet, he says, all those prophets that I chose, 124,000 prophets, Allah said, I chose other prophets, they are called Ulul Azm. They are better than the rest of them. And Allah compared them too with each other. For example, you go to the Quran, Allah talks about Prophet Muhammad and Prophet Yunus. They both are prophets, messengers of Allah. But then Allah told the Prophet, Ya Rasulallah, wala takun ka sahib al-hut. Don't be like Yunus. Ya Rasulallah, usually you and I, when we say don't be like him, because he's a bad guy. Right? Tell my son, don't be like him, because he's not doing something he's supposed to do. But here Allah is telling Rasulullah, la takun ka sahib al-hut. But here, the mufassirin, they say, Allah is telling Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, your maqam is not like maqam of Yunus, even though he's a prophet and messenger too. Right, so that we know that the difference. You go to Surah Al-Nisa, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah tells us, he said, tilka ar-rusul faddalna ba'dahum ala ba'd. Allah said, the messengers, even though they are all messengers, but their level is not the same. Some are better than the others. Allah is telling the Quran. Now, so when Allah said there are four best women, I want us to see how Allah described all of them. Now, the first one, in Surah Al-Tahrim, Allah talks about Asiya bint Muzahim. Asiya bint Muzahim was a wife of Fir'aun. She was married to him for so many years. Until the final days of Fir'aun, when Allah told Musa alayhi salam, idhab, go to Fir'aun, innahu tagha, faqula lahu qawla layyinan la'allahu yatadhakkar aw yakhsha. Allah sent them back to Fir'aun. Now, after everything that took place with the magicians, and the magician, they went to sajda, but they saw the truth, and they surrendered to Musa alayhi salam. The wife of Fir'aun, Asiya, she was sitting next to him, and she was watching. And she said to Fir'aun, Ya Fir'aun, I think what Musa is presented is not a magic. Fir'aun asked her, what do you mean? She said, I mean, he's a messenger. Fir'aun, la'anatullah alayhi, told her, he said, Ya Asiya, be quiet. Asiya didn't say anything in obedience to her husband. Then as Fir'aun became angry at the magicians and he wanted to punish them, he started making warnings, sending threats to them. لَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ عَلَى جُزُوءِ النَّخْلِ وَلَأَقَتَّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ مِنْ خِلَافِ. He said in the Quran, say, I'll cut your hands and the legs, right? If I cut left hand, I'll cut the right leg. So that way you cannot have balance, right? See, that's what I'm going to do to you. And not only that, I say, wala usallibannakum, I will crucify you for listening to Musa instead of me. Asiya alayhi salam, she was listening to this. Then she said to Fir'aun, Ya Fir'aun, I think what Musa is saying is truth. That's the second time. Fir'aun says, be quiet. Because I'm dealing with someone, I don't want to deal with you as my wife. Let me deal with them first. After the third one, Maryam, Asiya bint Muzahim, she said to him, Ya Fir'aun, now I'm not just telling you he is a messenger. I'm telling you I believe in him as a messenger of Allah. Allahu Akbar. When he said this, Fir'aun started boiling. He said to her, if you believe in what they believe, then whatever I'm going to punish them, you are going to be part of it too. And you know, Fir'aun, he was known in Surah Al-Fajr, when he punished, Fir'aun normally, he put four pillars. When he punished, he makes four pillars. And what he does, he then put the person in the middle and by tying their hands and their legs with those pillars. And that's why in Surah Al-Fajr, Allah said, وَفِرْعَوْنَ ذِلْ أَوْتَاد. Fir'aun, ذِلْ أَوْتَاد means the owner or the possessor of pillars for his punishment. So immediately he said to the armies, look, to Asiya, if you don't denounce for Musa now, I'm going to ask them to put you in the same way they do with everybody. Allahu Akbar. Look at the iman. When somebody gets to that level, when somebody becomes in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and see the nur, doesn't go back anymore. And you see Allah in Surah Al-Baqarah, He made a statement. He says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. It's a people who don't love Allah, who love other things. They love money, they love houses, they love cars more than Allah. But a mu'min, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. A true mu'min, their love is stronger in Allah. Nothing stop them. And one of them is Asiya. Now Asiya, she said, Ya Fir'aun, do whatever you want to do. I see the light. I'm not going back anymore. Then Fir'aun told his armies, go take him. Take her and put her between the pillars. And I'm coming to talk to her. They brought Asiya. They tied her. Allahu Akbar. Now imagine, she was the first lady to begin with. Fir'aun used to call himself Ana Rabbukum Al-A'la. And this woman, she used to live in castle. Everybody look up to her. And now she's been put in the middle for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fir'aun went to her himself. He walked down. He went to Asiya. Asiya was tied up. He looked at her and he said to her, Yeah, Asiya, denounce Musa and we go back home. She said, No, yeah, Fir'aun. I don't want to go back home. Then he made the people to turn her towards the castle where she used to live. He said to her, look, this is your house. Everything that you ask for is in this house. Just denounce Musa and that's it. Allahu Akbar. Asiya bint Muzahib, she turned and she said to Allah, and that's what the Quran says, قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. He said, Fir'aun is telling me, showing me his house that was built in this world. He said, that's not the house that I want. I want another house. Which house? He said, the house that was built next to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And look at it, our scholars in tafsir, they say, she said, رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ. That the word inda, they call it indiya. Next to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not next to Fir'aun. He said, وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنِ وَعَمَلِي وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Ya Allah, she asked Allah three things. Number one, رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Ya Allah, build for me a house next to you in the heaven. That's one. Number two, وَنَجِّنِي مِنْ فِرْعَوْنَ وَعَمَلِي. And Ya Allah, keep me away from Fir'aun and his actions. That's two. Number three, وَنَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And Ya Allah, protect me from all tyrant and oppressors. That is how Allah protected her. Now what happened? As soon as she asked Allah this dua, then Allah sent the angel of death. Right? Because at that moment, Fir'aun asked his armies, he said, I want you to bring a hot water and pour on her and burn her skin before she dies. You want to give her the most painful punishment. Right? When she made this, رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عَنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ, then Allah asked the angel of death, go and take her life before Fir'aun does whatever he wants to do. Right? So by the time Fir'aun comes to make his punishment, what happened? She already gone to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala quoted her in the Quran in Surah Al-Tahrim. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah said, we set an example for all men and women, those who believe. Imra'at Fir'aun, the wife of Fir'aun. إِذْ قَالَتْ رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Ya Allah, build me a house next to you in heaven and protect me from Fir'aun and his actions and protect me from all the oppressors. Now, that is how Allah describe Asiya, one of the best women in the world. Now in the same line, bring Zahra alayhi salam, just to know the difference between Zahra and Asiya. Now Zainab alayhi salam, she also quoted from Imam Hassan alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. She said, Imam Hassan said, I was in the room all night and my mother was making dua. Now me with Zahra is making dua and Asiya also made dua, quoted in the Quran, right? And what did she say? She said, رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ, and all the dua. Now Zahra was to make dua. What was her dua? Right? Imam al-Hassan said, I was in the room with my mother all night. And I was listening to her du'as. What was she saying? She said, كانت تقول اللهم اغفر لشيعة علي. Allahu Akbar. All the du'a that she was making, she was asking Allah, Ya Allah, I ask you to forgive to the Shia of Imam Ali alayhi salam. All night long. Allahu Akbar. He said, I was sitting, listening. If she will change another dua, I want heaven, I want money. Imam Hassan said, all night long, I did not hear anything other than dua for all the neighbors and mu'mineen. He said, I couldn't control myself. Imam Hassan, he said, I went to her. I said, Ya Ummah, ma li la tad'ina li nafsik. He said, all night I heard you making dua, but I never mentioned yourself. She said, yes. Bunayya al-Hassan, al-jar thumma al-dar. We Ahl al-Bayt, we always put our neighbors and our Shias first before anybody else. Allahu Akbar. Now look at the difference. Maryam alayhi salam, Asiya bint Muzahim, when she made dua, did she talk to anybody? No, it's all about her. Rabbi ibn li indaka baytan fil jannah wa naj'ni. It's all about her. But there was not even one mu'min mentioned in the ayah. But Zahra alayhi salam, when she raised her hand, the dua is not for her, it's for all the Shia of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. There is one of the maqamat al-Zahra, and there is one person is talking about themselves, and the other put the other people first before themselves. And that is Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. And that is why Quran talks about them. وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. They always put other people first before themselves. Allah, look at this quality. Where can you find people like Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam? Where they have the need, but somebody comes, they put the person first before themselves. That is Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Now that is number one. Number two. Another one, Maryam alayhi salam, in the Quran, in the same surah al-Tahrim, Allah said also about her, وَمَرْيَمَ إِبْنَةَ إِمْرَانَ الَّتِي أَحْسَنَتْ فَرْجَهَا. Maryam alayhi salam, who also protected herself. And the Maryam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed her with a son called Isa alayhi salam, the prophet. This Maryam alayhi salam, she spent all her life in the masjid, in the temple, praying. And Maryam alayhi salam, you know, she's not like any other lady too. She's one of the four best women. That when she was born, people came and they were fighting. And they want privilege who will take care of Maryam alayhi salam. To the point where Allah intervened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Maryam is not like any other woman. If anybody wants to come and take care of her, the person has to be chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, think about this. Today, you and I, when we want to babysit some, we want somebody to babysit our children, we go and find a person to make sure that the person is a good person who can raise our child. Now, Maryam alayhi salam, when she was born, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who chose who to babysit Maryam alayhi salam. And Allah tested all of them. How did Allah test them? And look in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to bring a bowl. And everyone should put his pen into that bowl. And any pen that stick out will be the one to be winning and will be the one to take care of Maryam alayhi salam. And all of them, including Zakaria, a prophet, a messenger of Allah, also has to go through that. When they throw their pen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about it to the prophet. وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ إِذْ يُلْقُونَ أَقْلَامَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ يَكْفُلْ مَرْيَمْ. Ya Rasulullah, you were not there when they all were throwing their pen to take the privilege of taking care of Maryam. وَمَا كُنْتَ لَدَيْهِمْ إِذْ يَخْتَسِمُونَ. You were not there when they were fighting for this privilege. But what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Prophet Zakaria to be the one to win to take care of Maryam alayhi salam. Maryam alayhi salam, she was in the Quran. Allah talks about her. She was always in the temple. Maryam alayhi salam, to the point one day, Quran talks about her that Zakaria enters, who brings her food every day. He walks in and he saw food around her. Then he asked her, Ya Maryam, Anna Lakiada, where did you get this? قالت من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. زكريا عليه السلام who took care of مريم عليه السلام. This Maryam, when she wanted to give birth to the Prophet and the Messenger of Allah, Allah told her, Ya Maryam, you have to leave the temple. Allahu Akbar. She's carrying a Prophet of Allah, one of the Ulul Azm, but Allah told her, Ya Maryam, you have to go out. Where? Quran told her, go and find a palm tree. وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْءِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطُ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا. Allahu Akbar. Allah, she was in the temple. She was getting her food every day. Now she wants to give a birth. Allah said, no, you have to go and find your own self, the food and the date, and you have to work for that food to come down for you, Ya Maryam. Now look at Maryam alayhi salam. But now come to Zahra alayhi salam. You know Zahra alayhi salam? One of the difference between Zahra and any other woman, according to the narrations, and that is why when we call her, we call her At-Tahira, purified. That the narration said, Zahra alayhi salam, when she gave birth to Imam Hassan and Imam Hussein and all their children, she stood up after a few minutes and performed her Salat al-Maghrib and Isha. Allahu Akbar. You know why? No women have this privilege except Zahra alayhi salam. That privilege to be able to communicate with Allah after birth, it's Zahra alayhi salam that Allah gave that. And that is one of the privileges that one here, وَطَهَّرَكِ, Allah purify her. One of the purification is this, not just the Isma. Isma is one of them, but one of them is Allah purified her in that sense. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Maryam, Ya Maryam, you have to go out to give birth to this great man that Allah ever brought to the people of that time, Isa alayhi salam. But when he came to Zahra alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Zahra, you can stay where you are and give birth to the wali of Allah and communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after your birth to this great son of yours, Ya Zahra. There is one of the difference between Zahra alayhi salam and Maryam. Not only that, the narration say about the food. One day the man came to Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, we want food. There is no food at home. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam said, go to the house of Zahra. Why the house of Zahra? Wallah, there is so many narrations that we need to think about. When the Prophet is pointing us to go to the house of Zahra, there is so much thing to learn. And one of them is, to learn that when you have any need, the house you should go to is the house of Zahra alayhi salam. Because even the sunnah of the Prophet in Hadith al-Kisa, Rasulullah, when he was feeling weak, he says he went to the house of Zahra and he says, Ya Zahra, inni ash'ur fi badani dha'fa. Allahu Akbar. Ya Rasulullah, your messenger, your Prophet, there is Masjid al-Nabawi, there is Kaaba, but he didn't go there, he went to the house of Zahra. Why? Because the house of Zahra is the house where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never say no to any person who goes to that house. And in Surah An-Nur, in Tafsir, they say Allah mentions, says, "Fi buyutin adhina Allahu an yudhkara fi." The house that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given permission to be mentioned and to be remembered is the house of Zahra alayhi salam. That is Zahra alayhi salam. Zahra, not only the brothers and sisters, maqama has a lot in the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he describes Zahra, he says, Ya Zahra, inna Allah yarda li ridaq. Wallah, there is nobody Allah ever put his pleasure in the hand of that person other than Zahra alayhi salam. That Rasulullah says, Ya Zahra, when you are pleased, Allah is pleased. Ya Zahra, when you are displeased, Allah is displeased. Allahu Akbar. What a maqam. And before the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, the Prophet was sitting around him. There were a few families. Imam Ali was there. Al-Hasan was sitting next to his feet. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam invited Zahra. Say, Ya Zahra, taqaddami, come closer. Zahra came. He said something in her ears. Then Zahra alayhi salam started crying. Allahu Akbar. When the Prophet saw Zahra was crying, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam couldn't take it. He called again, "Ya Zahra, come back again." Zahra came close to the Prophet. Then he said a word into her ears. Then she smiled. Then Imam Ali asked, "Ya Zahra, why a few minutes ago you were crying and now you're smiling?" Zahra said, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, the first call the Prophet told me that he's departing from this world. Ya Zahra, you are not going to see your father from this day. Your father is departing this world." So what was the second one? Look at Zahra alayhi salam. He said, the second call was to tell me, "You are the first one to meet me in Barzakh, Ya Zahra." Allahu Akbar. Anti sari'at al-lihaq bi fil barzakh. Ya Zahra, how old are you, Ya Zahra? I'm 18, Ya Rasulallah. And I'm going to be the next one going with you, Ya Rasulallah. Naam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked left and right. He said, "Ya Zahra, استعدي لبلاء." Get ready for the misfortune and trials to come after me, Ya Zahra. Because Rasulullah knows that after him, that house will be attacked. The house that Rasulullah, every morning he says, "As-salamu alayki ya Fatima, as-salamu alayki ya Ahl al-Bayt." And then the Prophet, after he says salam, Zahra will say to her, "Ya Rasulullah, al-baytu baytuk wal-kareematu kareematuk." Say, the house is your house and the daughter is your daughter. Why do you need to say salam, Ya Rasulullah? Then Rasulullah will say to Zahra, "Ya Zahra, Allah amarani bithalik." Say, Allah told me to ask permission before I come to your house. Ya Rasulullah, why? Because Allah knows some people will come and attack their house. Ya Rasulullah, don't be like them. Set an example. Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his last moment, is looking at his daughter Zahra alayhi salam, and his eyes was all covered with tears. Hey, look at Imam Ali alayhi salam. He said, "Ya Ali, taqaddam." Come closer, Ya Ali. Imam Ali came closer. He says, "Atini yadak." Open your hand. Imam Ali opened his hand. He said, "Ya Zahra, atini yadak." He took the hand of Zahra alayhi salam. He put it in the hands of Imam Ali. He said, "Ya Ali, hadihi wadi'ati andak." He said, "Ya Ali, this is my trust. I'm living behind with you. Please take good care of Zahra alayhi salam." Allahu Akbar. Because Rasulullah knows what will happen after this. Now, after Rasulullah, what happened? The first thing that happened, they attacked the house of Zahra alayhi salam. Asma said, "I was in the house when I heard the attack took place, and suddenly I heard Zahra, she screamed." And she said, "Ya Asma, taqaddami wasnidini." Allahu Akbar. She said, "Ya Asma, come help me to stand." I said, "What happened?" I said, "Kasaru zahari." Allahu Akbar. She said, "They broke my back. I can't stand." Allahu Akbar. Ya Zahra, when did this happen? Imam Ali alayhi salam was taken to the masjid by force against his will. Zahra alayhi salam, she was pregnant with the son. Rasulullah already gave him a name. He said to her, "Ya Zahra, sammi Muhsin." Name the son Muhsin. Allahu Akbar. Suddenly that Muhsin was lost in the process. Zahra alayhi salam, should I deal with my baby or should I deal with my back? Allahu Akbar. Zahra alayhi salam, she asked Asma to hold her together to the bed. She sat down. Zahra alayhi salam, she used to look at the masjid of the Prophet. She said, "Ya Rasulullah, where are you to see what is happening to me?" Zahra, she said, "Subbat alayya masa'ibun law annaha subbat ala al-ayyam sirna layaliya." She said, "Ya Rasulullah," she was talking to her father. She said, "Ya Rasulullah, where are you? Come and look at the tragedy that has been falling on me. If those tragedies are to be placed on the day will have turned to night, Ya Rasulullah." Then she asked Imam Ali alayhi salam, "Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I want a house called Bayt al-Ahzan." I want a place to sit down where I can cry and tell my trials and my troubles to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi, until the day of her shahada. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was gone. She lost her baby. Her back is broken. The day of her shahada, she told Asma. Asma helped to give Hassan and Hussein bath. She gave them bath, and then she said to Hassan and Hussein, "Go out to your father, Imam Ali, to the masjid." They left to the masjid. Then she called Asma. "Ya Asma, I'm going to read the Quran." But the moment you didn't hear any call in Quran, then that means I'm going to my father, to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. She opened the Quran and she was reading amazing Surah Al-Kahf, like Hussein on the day of Ashura. Alif Lam Mim, Alif Ha Kaf Ha Sad. She was reading Surah Al-Kahf, and imagine she was recording also the statement about Maryam alayhi salam that we mentioned about. And then after that, Asma said, "I was in the room listening to her recitation of the Quran, and I heard the voice was fading slowly by slowly." She said, "The more I hear, the voice was coming slowly." She said, "I come closer to keep listening," until the time came that I couldn't hear any sound. She said, "I rise to her and I saw her. She already left this world." She said, "I was standing looking at the janazah of Zahra alayhi salam. Then suddenly Al-Hasan and Hussein came to the room and they asked, 'Ya Asma, Aina Ummuna Zahra? Where is our mother Zahra?'" Asma alayhi salam, she said, I look at them, I didn't know what to say. I told them that your mother is sleeping. Now Imam Hassan and Hussein, they were looking at her, and Hussein asked her, "Ya Asma, this is not the time that our mother normally sleep. She normally doesn't sleep at this moment. Where is she?" "Allahu Akbar," she said, "I told her this is your mother Zahra alayhi salam." She said, as soon as I pointed her to them, they rushed to her, and she rushed, they all dropped their bodies on the body of Zahra alayhi salam. Asma said, "I was standing there looking at this scene, and Imam Hussein was saying, 'Ya Umma, kallimini, oh my mother, speak to me.'" She said, "This is the first time the respondent didn't come. The second time the respondent didn't come." And he said the third time, "Ya Umma, kallimini, kabla an yakhruja ruhi min badani." So, "Oh my mother, speak to me before my spirit departed from my body." She said, as soon as they said this, Imam Ali walk in. The narration said, as he walks in, he heard a call come from the sky saying to Ya Ali, "Inna al-malaikata la tutiqu hadha al-manzar." The angels cannot stand this look. "Irfa al-Husayn an Zahra alayhi salam." Please lift Zahra, lift Hussein, because the angels cannot look at this manzar. Allahu Akbar. Asma said, "I was there after the shahada of Zahra. Wallahi, I saw like Zahra was hugging Hussein. Even though after she passed, she's still hugging Hussein alayhi salam." There is Asma alayhi salam. But amazing, brothers and sisters, the last moment, Imam Ali alayhi salam, he said that before Zahra passed, she wrote a will, "Ya Ali, udfunni laylan." He said, "When you bury me, I want you to bury me at night. Wadfunni idha namat al-ayun, when the eyes are asleep." Ya Zahra, you are the daughter of Rasulullah. Why should you be buried at night? He said, "I don't want those people to come to my janazah. Inni ghadibatun anhum, wala uridu lahum tashi'a janazati." Allahu Akbar. And he said, "Ya Ali," she said, "Ya Ali, ikra li surat Yasin wa surat Safat. After I pass, I ask you to read me surat Yasin and Safat." Imam Ali alayhi salam quoted that, "Ya Zahra, la'un'imannaki adhihi al-matalib. I will honor everything that you requested." But Imam Ali alayhi salam said that when during the time of ghusl of Zahra alayhi salam, she said, "Wallahi, every time I went one part, I said the part itself turned for me without me turning the body of Zahra alayhi salam." Asma said, as we were in the ghusl, I saw Imam Ali turn towards the door and he started screaming, As Asma said, I ask Ya Ali, why? He said, Wallahi laqad ra'aytu dhahra al-maksura. I saw the broken bone. I saw where that nail went into the body of Zahra. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Wa sayaklamu alladhina zalamu ayyamun kalamin yankalibun. Ya Hussein. Ya Hussein.
خوب کی حفاظت حرام باد بعد قتل سیدنا ہر درود اور ہر سلام قاہر حسین تیرے نام ہر درود اور ہر سلام قاہر حسین تیرے نام بی بی غم اٹھائے ہیں بہت دل پہ داغ اٹھائے ہیں بہت تجھ پہ اے حسین کی بہن ہو گئی مصیبتیں تمام ہر درود اور ہر سلام
قاہر حسین تیرے نام
ہر درود اور ہر سلام
قاہر حسین تیرے نام
دولت بتول لٹ گئی دختر رسول لٹ گئی چھن گئی سروں سے چادریں جل گئے حسین کے خیام ہر درود اور ہر سلام
ہر حسین تیرے نام
ہر درود اور ہر سلام
ہر حسین تیرے
ہر درود اور ہر سلام دختر حسین تیرے نام ہر درود اور ہر سلام
دختر حسین تیرے نام
شمر کے تماچے کھائے ہیں بی بی کتنے غم اٹھائے ہیں باپ کی جدائی کم نہ تھی اس پہ قید شام ستم دھام ہر درود اور ہر سلام
دختر حسین تیرے نام
ہر درود اور ہر سلام
دختر حسین تیرے نام
بی بی آپ پر ستم ہوئے مر گئی پدر کا غم لیے آئے جیتے جی نہ چھٹ سکا قید خانہ امیر شام ہر درود اور ہر سلام
دختر حسین تیرے نام
شہادت
ہر درود اور ہر سلام دختر حسین تیرے
کیا ستم حسین کے دل پر گزر گئے کیا کیا ستم حسین کے دل پر گزر گئے کیا کیا ستم حسین کے دل پر گزر گئے کیا کیا ستم اکبر گزر گئے علی اصغر گزر گئے کیا کیا ستم حسین کے دل پر گزر گئے مشکل تھی راہ حق میں ہر ایک منزل وفا مشکل تھی علی کا نام بہتر گزر گئے، کیا کیا
ستم حسین
کے دل پر گزر گئے،
فوجوں کو چیرتے ہوئے عباس نام سے مثل ہے در صف در گزر گئے،
کیا ستم حسین کے در گزر گئے،
ارمان لاکھوں دل میں تھی مادر لیے کے جب آئے تو اکبر گزر گئے،
کیا کیا ستم
حسین کے دل پر گزر
گئے،
جب یاد آ گئی کبھی زینب کو کربلا،
جب یاد آ گئی کبھی
کیا نظر کے سامنے منظر گزر گئے،
کیا کیا ستم حسین
دیتی رہی دعائی بہن بعد قتل شاہ،
دیتی رہی
لاشوں کو روندتے ہوئے لشکر گزر گئے،